G'day everyone, my name is Jesse from Oasis Lawns and today we'll be reviewing the 525 LST from Husqvarna.
Louis Vuitton umbrella when I walk through the rain. In the kitchen whipping chicken kind of bread like Kane. Good dog got a mess, good looking like Johnny Dine. Deep, deep muddy water stick, can my cane. Right pocket got money, left pocket cocaine. Bulletproof white Cadillac riding in the tank. I'm a dirty bike baby from Dirty Bike with a dirty case. Slide down your block, light it up with flame. Chopping on the block, wide leg, doing jumper jacks. Smoking on the wood, yellow temper like it's lumberjack.
So within my business, I'm currently running the 525 LST from Husqvarna, and I'm also running the KM94 from Steel. I have two of these. This one is my line trimmer model. It's just kept as a line trimmer, and then I actually have a combi unit itself. But today I'll be comparing the 525 to the KM/FS94. I'll also be comparing it to the Bushranger L261. If you're a regular on the channel, you'll see that I had that for a while. I switched back to both my 94s. Wasn't really a fan of the weight, and then we also switched over the handles, which wasn't a great idea. That was my fault. I thought, you know what? I've had the 525 before, let's give it another crack. This time I'm gonna put a Kawasaki handle on, because last time I did have it, it did hurt my back a little bit, but besides that, it's a great machine. And I think a large majority of my stuff is, as I'm still young, I don't properly use these machines to their full capability. And that's why I don't get the best out of them. But I wanted to talk about this. I've had it for about 3 weeks now. I've also had it, last time I had it for about, had it for about 2 months, until I sold it and bought the Bushranger. But I thought, you know what, I'll go through the pros and cons of this machine, what I dislike and what I like, and yeah, let's get into it. So one of the pros of this machine is the power. It does, on paper, have equivalent power, or near equivalent power, to the KM94 and the Bushranger L261. However, where this machine shines is within the gearbox. So the gearbox is actually a high torque gearbox, and that's what the T stands for in 525 LST. It's a high torque gearbox. It'll put out a faster head speed than what you would on, say, for example, a KM94. I don't know the exact mechanical aspect behind it, but I know that's why it's got more power and it can get through that thicker stuff, especially around here with all the rye, and the kikuyu and the buffalo that we take care of in these Australia, especially Melbourne. It just powers through it like crazy. So that is definitely a massive plus for me. I can also run about half to double the line depending on the environment I'm using in. It won't bog down and it won't have any issues. Another one of my favorite features about this is the weight of it. I think with the Kawasaki handle, these don't come with it obviously. You have to buy them separate. You can buy them from All Mail Spares, probably wouldn't recommend it. I haven't had great delivery time. I think this one alone took 6 months to get, just the handle. But with the Kawasaki handle, I found especially is that it's very comfortable, it's very lightweight, and it's very well balanced, right? The Bushranger was balanced. Had quite a bit of weight down this end with its head, which was okay, but I prefer these speed feed heads. And it also had quite a lot of weight down this end, which made it balanced, but it was quite heavy. This is quite light, but, sorry, I should put it up. This is quite light. It doesn't have the equivalent power, I believe, due to the high torque gearbox. And therefore, I don't know. I just felt like I wasn't getting enough power for the weight of it. Although it is light, this is probably lighter, not by much, but when you're using it, it's more comfortable to use, I believe, and that's where it shines. Along with the ergonomics itself, I quite like the handle. It is plastic, but I feel like it's more comfortable on this than it is to the 94. I don't know, maybe I've just used these for too long, but this is actually quite nice. I have put my equipment defender brackets on it for my equipment defender racks. We are looking at going to Green Touch soon. But as for now, on the current trailer setup I'm rocking, I'm using equipment defender. Speed feed head, obviously, that has been put on by me. Now for the negatives. Once again, like I said, Kawasaki handle was put on myself. I don't really like the handle that comes with it. I find it, it's not good. And I think that was the issue on the last one. I very much don't like that handle. I'd much rather use the 94 handles or the handles on the steels altogether. The second would be the fuel tank. Now, the fuel tank is an issue, but not an issue. I get the amount of fuel it goes through for the power it the power it has. It goes through quite a bit of fuel. And I understand that, but at the same time, I wish the fuel tank was a bit bigger. It does go underneath, but it goes to about there. It isn't much. It's mainly all here. I did 11 lawns solo about 2 weeks back after a day or so of getting this. I got this just for that. I did 11 yards solo. I probably went through 3 or 4 tanks. I used it on every property. This, the K94, I'd probably only go through about 2. So, look, very dependent, but I am willing to pay that bit extra in fuel to get a high performance machine than a maintenance machine. That does not do well through long grass. I put it through a massive cleanup the day before I bought this, and it just underperformed. It was crazy. And I was like, you know what? Maybe I'll give the Husqvarna another try. I have not been disappointed. Now, would I buy this or this? Now, this is a very dependent question on a few things, and I've got to kind of ask a few questions to get yourself the answer you want. One, it's pretty cliche at this point, but dealer support is the biggest thing ever. I think that if you have a good steel dealer, you should buy steel. If you have a good Husqvarna dealer, you should buy Husqvarna. I wouldn't be supporting any dealer that doesn't support me. At the end of the day, when shit happens, I need to keep going, and I need a dealer I can rely on. Another thing that it relies on is that, do you want a standalone unit or a combi unit, I guess? Husqvarna does make a combi unit of this. It does not have the high torque head. A lot of people think that they're going to get the high torque head, and they don't, and then it ends up being another KM94 just in a Husqvarna brand. So starting out, I'd probably buy this. If you don't want this and you want to buy standalone units, definitely invest in a 525. It's very brand dependent. I don't have a definitive answer. I mean, it all comes down to personal preference as well. There's a few other things I haven't discussed, but I don't want to bore you guys. The throttle itself, this is okay. This is a little less, this is more flimsy, but I like it a little more. The weight, this does have a bit more weight because of the coupling and whatnot. I don't know if you can see that, but it does have that bit extra weight. But it's very dependent on what you want. Some people like the handles better. I don't like the easy start. The start on this is a lot nicer. But yeah, it's what you want at the end of the day. And that's about it. Hopefully I didn't bore you guys for way too long. Anyway, hopefully I'll be posting a bit more often. If not, sorry. but yeah. Anyway, have a great day, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.